Have you any queries? First paragraph is okay. Is this new book with gravitational, with ray optics or not? Which is 15th chapter in this book? 15th chapter, chapter 15. Second book, chapter 15. This year ray optics is added as chapter 15. No, this is the old one. Okay, let's start. SI system, International System of Unit. The International System of Unit. Actually, initially it was MK system, meter, kilogram, second. But the limitation is only three quantities, provision for only three physical quantities: mass, length and time. Then comes another CGS system. Length is measured in centimeter, mass in gram and time in second. MKS means meter, kilogram, second. Then third one, FPS. CGS system was used in America, USA. FPS was used in earlier times in Britain. Feet, pound, second. As India was slave, time 200 years, up to 200 years. Britain has control over India. So at that time the books written have FPS system. Then comes MKSA, not mentioned in the book, MKSA. The fourth quantity, current, is also entertained. It is also added. But all these are deficient in some aspects, such as rationality, coherency. These are different aspects we can associate as properties of this system later. Now, internationally accepted system is SI system, full form System International. System International. So, at present, all the countries are using same SI system. At present, the books are written, all books are written in SI system. It consists of seven fundamental units and quantities. So, what are those seven fundamental units? We have to discuss about them. First is meter. One standard meter. How to define it? One standard meter. Can you define it? Initially, thumb rule was used. How? Assume Earth is spherical. Actually, Earth is flattened at the poles. It is just like an orange. Polar radius is smaller than equatorial radius. By how much kilometer do you know? 22 kilometer. That's why acceleration due to gravity is greater at the poles. 9.88 meter per second square. Lesser at the equator, 9.78 meter per second square. The value we are using, 9.8 meter per second square, is the average of these two. Suppose Earth is spherical. And its radius, do you know? What is the radius of our Earth? 6,400 kilometer. If we convert it in meter, scientific notation 6.4. 30 comes from here, kilometer 30 from here, so 10 power 6 meter. If I calculate the circumference two pi r, then how much? 2 pi, 6.28 multiplied by 6.4 into 10 power 6 meter. When I calculate this, I got approximately 4 into 10 to power 7 meter. Now, if I divide this whole circumference in 4 parts and take distance from one of the pole to the equator, 1/4 of this, then this distance becomes 1/4 of this, means suppose the distance is x, then I can write x as 10 to the power 7 meter. So can you now define 1 meter? 1 by 10 to the power 7th part, 1 by 1 crore part, this is 1 crore. So 1 upon 10 to the power 7th part of the distance from equator to any of the pole is equal to 1 meter. So if you want to compare, if you want to compare, we want to measure, can we go and measure that, compare it? Is it easy? No. So this standard is not well defined. It is not easily accessible. So we defined it again in terms of bar standard. So this is first approach, it is called thumb rule. No need to revise it, just understand in single attempt, never read it again. This much detail discussion once is sufficient. So what is second approach? Bar standard. In periodic table you can find platinum easily, superior than gold. You can also find iridium. Mixing both, we can make an alloy. So we use platinum iridium alloy and made a rectangular bar. On which we engraved two parallel lines. Two parallel lines are engraved on platinum iridium alloy bar. Why we use platinum iridium alloy? Because its wear and tear is negligible with time. It remains intact. We engraved two parallel lines and also put two golden plugs there for identification. Golden plugs made of gold. The distance between these two parallel lines is 1 standard meter, and we preserve it in bureau, at bureau in Paris. It is correct statement, or in bureau at Paris is correct? Which sentence is correct? I am checking your English. My English is poor, but I am checking yours. At bureau in Paris or in bureau at Paris?
In bureau at Paris.
Confirm. Or
at Paris, in
you are doubtful.
Doubtful.
These are preserved in bureau at Paris, or at bureau in Paris. You can confirm it with help of English teacher. So bar standard, this distance is defined, but some drawbacks are there. Whenever we want to compare, go to Paris. This is primary standard. So that problem is solved. What we have done, we compared it and made secondary standards and provided one each to each country. So we can compare from that secondary standard. But problem is again there. It is not available at all the places. It is not an easy reach of us. And one day, suppose if earthquake comes and that whole bureau goes into earth, we will lost our standard. So there must be one property which we want to set as a standard, and that property, it should be reproducible at least. So reproducible property is not associated with bar standard. We defined it again as wavelength standard. Are you familiar with this name? Wavelength standard? You know wavelength. What is wavelength? Okay. If I represent a wave like this, crest trough, then the distance from here to here is called one wavelength, which includes one crest and one trough, or the distance between corresponding points, distance between two consecutive crests, or distance between two consecutive troughs is called one wavelength, represented by lambda. So have you watched any movie of Superman? No. Do you know Superman is cartoon character? In movie, stories, they told that Superman came from Krypton. Krypton is also an element in our periodic table. The Krypton shown in movie is of green color. It radiates green color radiations. But in actual, Krypton radiates orange color radiations. Krypton has atomic number 86 and it radiates orange color radiation. Please verify whether it is atomic number or mass number. Check it from periodic table. At present, do you know 86 atomic number or mass number for Krypton? This is atomic number. All mass numbers are in 3 digit. Fair. Then check it. So how to define wavelength standard? In terms of wavelength, we defined the length 1 meter again with help of sophisticated instrument like interferometer. It become possible for us to measure the wavelength. So we define wavelength standard. There is some data, no need to learn it. Just here once. If we take 1650763.73 number of waves, this much number, this much wavelength of orange color radiation, emitted by Krypton 86, then these spread in 1 meter, one standard meter. Yet there is some problem regarding accuracy. this cannot be measured with more accuracy, which is required for certain measurement. We needed more accurate measurement than this. So finally we defined 1 meter in terms of speed of light. So what is speed of light? Represented by C. It is called light standard. C is 3 × 10⁸ m/s. Is it exact value or approximate? It is approximate. Exact 2.998, something like that. So we can calculate the distance traveled by light in 1 second is, in 1 second, light travels 3 × 10⁸ m in 1 second. So it will travel 1 meter in 1/3 × 10⁸ s. So we can define that the distance traveled by light in 1/3 × 10⁸ fraction of second is equal to 1 standard meter. So just like we define 1 meter. Similarly, 1 standard kg, kilogram. So do you know 1 standard kg? How to define it?
There is cylinder.
What is special about this cylinder? The diameter of this cylinder is equal to its height. Diameter and height are same. And it is also made of platinum iridium alloy because of less wear and tear. It is again preserved in controlled atmospheric conditions, that is 0 degree centigrade temperature and 1 atmospheric pressure in Bureau at Paris. Mass of this cylinder is equal to 1 kg. What about practical standard? Practically, how much we take as 1 kg? Pardon?
1 liter of water.
At particular temperature. Can you tell me a practical detail? If you go to market and purchase 1 liter ghee or 1 liter oil, and from some other shop you purchase 1 kilogram ghee or 1 kilogram oil. So you will get more quantity from shop 1 or shop 2. Definitely 1 kg will be more, greater than 1 liter quantity. In quantity, 1 kg is greater. So it will also cost more. 15 kg of tin of oil costs more than 15 liter. Why? It is because of density. Whenever we convert it in liter, then quantity become lesser. So these days all the vendors are measuring oil, ghee, etc. in liter instead of kilogram. Initially they were trading in kilogram, but they found more profit in liter and standardized it as liter, as that is liquid. But density matters. So oil to oil we can compare. Oil having more density compared to some other oil, amount become different if we measure in kilogram. But if we measure in liter, amount will be same. So practical standard, we know that all substances expand on heating. Is it true? All substances expand, or some substances are there which contract on heating? Do you know some substances which contract on heating?
What about diamond?
Diamond, it expands on heating. It is rubber which contracts.
Rubber.
It is thermocol. Plastic, which contracts on heating. Uniformly or not uniformly, doesn't matter. But in case of water, it matters. When you pour some ice on water, it floats. What does it indicate? Ice is solid form. Almost all the solids are more denser than liquid state. But ice is less denser. Its volume is greater. That's why ice floats on water. Archimedes' principle. So, what is special about water? When we cool it up to 4 degrees centigrade, it is called anomalous behavior of water. And it is very, very important for survival of aqua life, aquatic plants, aquatic animals. Otherwise, they can't survive in winter season. The whole water body will freeze. But what happens? Till we cool water 4 degrees centigrade, its density increases. And it is most dense at 4 degrees centigrade. And after that, further cooling make it less denser. Its volume increases in moving from 4 degree to 0 degree. Volume increases. That's why ice is less denser than water. So what happens in winter season? The water bodies, lakes, etc., get freeze from top, and that ice floats on top, and it prevents cold to transfer. Or prevents cold to transfer, we can say that cold to transfer to lower layer. Below that layer of ice, water is present. So aquatic life is safe. Water is present at what temperature? 4 degrees centigrade. So 1 liter of water, practical standard, 1 liter of water at 4 degrees centigrade have mass how much? 1 kilogram. Exactly. But only at particular temperature, 4 degrees centigrade. Have you heard about atomic standard? Again, we can define 1 kg in terms of atomic mass. So mole concept, you are familiar with mole concept? You don't know mole concept? In chemistry, you should have learned about mole concept. 1 mole of any substance consists of Avogadro number 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 number of atoms, molecules, particles, whatever, ions, etc. So it is called mole concept. So can we find how many atoms are there? How many atoms of carbon are there present in 1 kg? If I give you an exercise, find number of carbon atoms in 1 kg of 1 kg mass. So can you find it? Try it. How many carbon atoms are there in 1 kg?